All right. Welcome back, everyone. We got a quick turnaround here, so give me a second. I was a little late getting in for my run. I intended on doing this other race, but looks like we're going to do the same route as last week. So, Climber's Gambit on tap. Get some music going. Hope you enjoy. Evening, Matthias. Thanks for joining. It's the route again. So that's the one with the hilltop finish. As I said, wasn't really intending on doing this one. So soon after, the last, where apparently it said a peak all-time 10-minute power. I believe it was 387 for 10 minutes. So like, a lot. 6.6, something like that. But ran out of time. The run conditions were slow, so didn't have time post run to get in. Oh, smokes. Frame rates will improve. They look abysmal right now on my end too. Sick part of the song. Week's Sufferfest, but no other option. So we're gonna try a couple little different things this time, so it's not identical. competition will be. There's a Spanish guy somewhere in here. Moreno or something. Thank you, Brett. Thank you. A nice song idea coming after this one. Found this one last night. It's beautiful. Well, I mean, the start's really good, but then it kind of peters out a bit, and then it gets good again. Thank you. Thanks for joining, everyone. We've got a good turnout. Appreciate all the support. Exactly. That's what it's all about. We're not gonna just try the same move every time, even though I really have one move, but we're gonna try to change the placements, see what works, see what doesn't work, have some fun in the process. The workouts are where the gains are made. These are just for fun, so may as well have some fun with it and try some things up. Whatever. This one is on an assigned bike again, I believe. We're on like a giant something. Propel? I don't know. Beautiful. So I'm just gonna sit in here as much as I can. It's not really sitting in on this little punch, but you know what I mean. All right, this is the song. Just wait for the intro. It's wicked. Just wait a sec. Maybe the bass will drop as soon as we get to the hill, but it takes some time to build up to it. I'll turn it up. You feel it building. Yes, it did, George. think it's a giant something. But I believe my lightweight wheels are on it. The climbing wheels, they should be. So last time, last week I did a stupid attack here. It wasn't even an attack, that's the thing. In Zwift, you gotta commit to attacks. Like, halfway doesn't get you anything, it just burns energy. The draft is so big, right? If you just say, I'm just gonna hold six, it's not gonna do anything. Like holding threshold doesn't do anything. So I did a dumb one where I'm like, I'm just gonna hold threshold through Titans. It's just a waste of energy. It's not even burning a match, it's just energy. Just wasted energy. So this time we're gonna sit in a little bit more. Seems a lot tamer, I'd say, at this point, than the last time. Unfortunately, that normally means that the final climb is gonna be more painful. Last time, I believe we were 380 on it, and I think 387 normalized for a 1340. Who's off the front here? Why doesn't it ever show you? Exactly. You know it. Because you do, watching your races, some long attacks. Like me, I think. I do a little bit shorter, but like not as long of an attack, but I saw your one from, I don't know, it was a week or two ago, and it was from way, way out. And you know that, as you saw, like you were pushing like, what, 2.5 watts per kilogram more? And you won, and it worked, but it's just amazing how like the pack can sit at 3, right, and you push 6. And it's like, it doesn't go up as fast as it should. Oh great, I'll watch it. I'm excited. Here's my afternoon. Done. See, those guys came back with zero effort. Put by the group, and they came back no problem. Sorry for not talking here, just need to pay attention on these rollers always. Don't want to get caught off guard. Oh, up into my resistance. Spin it out. Hopefully that doesn't happen again. Resistance totally dropped up there. There we go. Whoa. Yeah, now I'm in a big gear. Tough when your trainer's not cooperating. Thanks a lot, Saris. Dangerous spot. They're gonna come fast here. Come on, Mo, tilt up, baby. Come on. I don't want to get spat out here. Phew, I think there's a little help coming up. Thanks, Henry. That other group's gonna catch. Maybe not. We'll see. Yeah, they're coming. Oh yeah. Oh well. Dropped them once, I'll drop them again. Back together. That wasn't the move, by the way. So, just in case wondering. Down as much as we can. It always stays high during the race. Just because I'm tense and the little fluctuations in power, but 150 is pretty good. Putting 149. And 140. 147 coming at you. Nah. Yeah, there we go. It's too early. Just queued up my music. Oh, this is very easy. All right. I think the real question of today, like I said, I wasn't planning on doing this climbing race so soon after the last. The real question of today, I think, is going to be just how willing am I to go to that place again? So, pumping myself up, obviously, is an important thing. Committing, not being worried if anything goes wrong, and not trying to compare it to the last week. It's its own race, it's different dynamics. Different competitors, so, but physically, I feel fine, feel okay. Not amazing, but it's good enough. It's all gonna come down mentally. Do I wanna go to that place again? I think I do. I felt it a little bit on Titans there, like, ooh, I wanna rip these pedal off right now. That's not long enough climb, so easy, big fella. But we'll see what happens in a couple minutes. Thank you. Thanks for joining in. This is like downright tranquil. We're gonna hit this climb hard, I think. That's a lot of grain right there. Pretty much cued. I'm turning up, everyone, so I'll see you on the other side. Thank you.
Thank you.
What if? Hey, Ted, what? .372 for 16 minutes. .40 seconds over. A win. Time on the climb, 14:08. So 28 seconds slower than last week. But so low. And yeah, no one in sight. Thanks, everyone. They just let me go, thinking, what's this guy gonna do? Oh, I'll show you what he's gonna do. I'll show you. He's gonna hold, 6.3 for 16 minutes with freewheeling in there. Yeah, that's what he's gonna do. Whew. Felt okay. Very controlled, actually, for the first, say, 12 minutes of that attack. Last little bit, feeling it for sure, but no one was in sight at that point, so. Beautiful. Whew. Singing good music, too. Time sucks, but yeah, last week was a lot harder than that. This was like, as I said, I'm gonna control this race as much as I can, so just in case someone comes, we'll have a little bit left, but we're just gonna match their watts per kilogram plus one or two. Like 0.1 or 2, you know what I mean? And yeah, got the win. Whew, looks like we got a awesome crew here. Thank you. Thank you, everyone. And thank you, Scotty Weiss, so much for joining. Means a lot coming from you. Best climber on Zwift. Whew, had some horrendous gear changes. But I thought I almost dropped it like twice. Just was not, you know what it was? So I talked about it on that out workout from, what was that, two nights ago? That, like, you gotta anticipate the gradients, right? So that you're not changing last second. And today, the problem was that I was staring at my computer so much because I was trying to control, like I was trying to control the power quite a bit. Like I set numbers for myself. So I'm like, at the beginning, you know, try to stay under 420 so we're not like, you know, burning anaerobic power. And try to hold about 375, 380 average. I think I was about 380 something through the first half of that. Then started easing off a bit, especially on the descent. And then said, okay, when you're out of the saddle, bring up the average by, you know, 1 or 2 watts, and then go back in the saddle and just hold 370. So point was, is I was staring at the Garmin so much, controlling the power as much as I could to try to keep it like as steady as possible of an effort on what is really quite a punchy little climb. Like, there's quite significant gradient changes, ups and downs, there's downhills in it. And I eased right off on the downhill, which cost a lot of power, but gave me a little respite. But yeah, I was staring so much at the Garmin that I really didn't pay much attention to the gradient changes, which was a big mistake. So if I do this again, like, maybe I'll do something, one of those things, because I am using a PC right now. So maybe I'll have something where I can get, like, I'd love if I can get average power on the screen. So I could look at that instead of looking down, and I'll put it like right there by the gradients or something like that. So that'd be a good idea, because I really didn't do a good job of working the terrain that much. It kind of like caught me off guard a bunch of times and tanked the cadence down to 50, and then had to make a gear change under extremely high chain tension. So you see like massive dips in power. But any case, can't be too upset with that. It was 372 for 16 minutes. And normalized, let's just call it 376. So, solid. 8 watts less on the climb, I think, this time than the last time. But, win's a win. Got the job done. Got in 16 minutes of, call it upper threshold. So, above out pace, so that's good. As long as it's, that was kind of my thing as I was going across the bridge there, I'm like, well, buddy, you're gonna hold 357 for 34 minutes, so you better believe that you can hold 357 across this bridge. If you do anything less than that, I'm gonna smack you. So, it was good to have a little number in mind, and a good workout in the end. So, 16 minutes above the pace by 15 watts above pace, and normalized probably, you know, 20 watts above pace. So a perfect workout. And thank you for watching, everyone. We got such a great turnout. This is awesome. Let me get to the bottom. Well, you know what I'll do? I'll just put it on this screen. Let's get this train on the road here a bit. I always kind of stop my cool downs when I get in back into about the 200s. That's my measuring stick for how recovered we are. Yeah, thank you everyone. Just scrolling through the messages. Wow, we got a ton. This is awesome. Debatable to say it's shorter. Thank you. Yeah, that one on Wednesday was pretty rapid. It was 37 minutes. 37.08, doing 3 minutes on, 1 minute off. So it had 9 minutes of recovery in it. And we went 37.08. The ons, I think I averaged up in the end. I think they were 365 average. So, and feeling very controlled. My heart rate didn't even touch what it touched today. It was very, like, odd today. It stayed really steady, but 180 felt like 185, if you know what I mean. Felt a little bit harder than what the heart rate, I think, suggested. But I did actually, not to, you know, talk down at my efforts so much, but you too, Scotty, thanks for joining. And I'll check out that race this afternoon. I'm excited. Excited to see it. Thanks so much for joining. What was I saying? The first 12 minutes of that actually were like, I don't know what I'm gonna, when I go back and check the tapes, I think I usually account for half my views. Because I watch it a number of times, see what I'm looking like, kind of dissect things. What could I do better? Where did I lose time? Here I already know I lost huge time on the descents and the things right up from the descent. It's just I was too nervous to spike the power. I did not want to spike the power like over 420 or so, and start just burning through here or burn out. So I was very careful to keep it like a truly aerobic, high end aerobic effort. The first, I don't know, 75% of that felt extremely well controlled. Last a little bit was hurting, but not bad, not bad at all. There was enough to do another 4 minutes or so, for sure, which would be a 370, you know, let's call it 375 FTP test at the end of a race, which is actually my best 20 minute power, so to do that and feel like pretty good, like not bad, especially with like a surge on the start. Not a long surge, it was just enough. The thing is I don't need to do, you know, 600 watts for 30 seconds and then have to spend, you know, the important part of that climb, the first little bit, have to spend that recovering. That'd be terrible, right? We want to be able to hit that truly. And a big part of breakaways is always breaking spirits of people. If you can basically make them feel like, ah, oh, this guy's gone, and start playing between each other for a second, that's the goal, right, of any of these breakaways. You want them to forget about you, right? And I think if you do a big spike, and then they were to get within like a decent amount on that little stretch, then they'll start believing again. But if you do like what I did there, which I think worked well, like a controlled hard 20, 30 seconds, get 5, 6, 7 seconds on them, and then like recover at like, you know, 7, if we can call it that, recovery, and then just have that gap go a little bit more, a little bit more, a little bit more, a little bit more, a little bit more. Instead of, I think if they see you, if they sense weakness in you, right, and they see you dipping down to 4, right, because you're recovering, truly recovering from a massive effort, I think they're going to believe that, oh, this guy's done, he's petering up. But if you can keep, like, very high tempo, and they know, like, this is real, I don't know. This is just my opinion, but I think that's all that was needed there. I didn't think I needed to do 600 watts for 30 seconds, you know? And as I said, end up having to truly recover. I wanted to make this like a controlled burn on them and just have that grow bigger and bigger and bigger. And then once it gets up to 20, 30 seconds, I mean, when it was at like 30 seconds in the final 2K, like, unless I drop my chain, they ain't catching me. I know that, like, I knew I won, you know, six minutes to go, basically. Right? They ain't catching me with 30 seconds head start here. So, anyways, it's good tactics. I think it worked. So, I don't know if it's actually good tactics, but it worked. As I said, the timing of that was important. Because that first part of the climb is where you can make a lot of time or lose a lot of time. And if I was having to go at 6 watts per kilogram up that initial 2-minute cliff, basically, up the bridge, to the bridge, I think I would have got caught. They would have started to see the deficit. This is what I'm talking about. They would have started to see the deficit start coming down and then believe, like, oh, we got this guy. He's dead. He's burning out. Right, instead, what did they see? They saw that deficit get bigger and bigger and bigger. And broke their spirit. Alright. So, take a look at the graph. How long? Well, you know what I'll do? I'll stop in 1 minute so I can let you guys go. And I'm going to keep cooling down on my own for another 15 minutes. As I said, until I get that power back into the 200s. Consistently. So, and then we'll jump off, do some strength. All right, let's take a look at the graph. Come on, get to 115, there we go. 20 seconds. I thought that the Spanish guy was going to really put on some pressure, but, and they were going, they were moving at one spot, like about maybe, you know, 6 minutes into things. Holy jumping. What the heck is going on here? Gears feel horrible. Whew. All right, yeah, so I'll take a look at the graph and then I'll cool down, but I'll let you guys go first, so. So it should be 372 for 1601 or something like that. Let's see what she looked like. And I don't think I'm gonna get any real points for it. I might, because that guy, the Spanish guy, was ranked. He had, like, his race ranking was like 84 or something like that, or 82. So a very high ranking. So I should be moving up a little bit, because that should erase one of my poorer ones. Whew! That looks disgusting. I don't think it was all red like that, but hey, it makes a darn pretty picture, as usual. That's my sixth message today saying my iCloud storage is full. I don't even think I have an iCloud, but, like, sure. 1,759 photos and 311 videos. Your iCloud storage is full. Interesting. Add or manage storage. I don't know. Like, I don't even think I have iCloud. Do I? Where's that? I don't know. Where do I find all that stuff? This looks pretty. Remember, I don't know if these are official. I think I did my FTP test on another computer. But I think that's pretty close. Ugh. You know what's funny? Here's what's funny. So, and then I'll let you guys go. Actually, let me just see what some of the other powers look like. So 372 was the actual effort. I think it was 1608 or something like that. So it's good to see that Zwift actually was right for once. Let's see, 10 minute power. So about maybe let's call it 10 watts less than the last one. Or it says right there, 7 watts less than the last one. Normalizes higher, obviously. 5 minute, pretty weak, but it's fine. You got the job done. So I'm not going to move up in Z points at all with that kind of an effort. There's what I was going to say, and then I let you guys go. Where did I initially want to attack? Well, I'll tell you. Before this race, I checked out, and I'm like, so I want to move my 20-minute power on Zwift Power up to what it actually is, which is about 372, 375 normalized or so. I want a 20-minute effort. So I'm like, I went to Climber's Gambit race from last week, and I saw, okay, the climb started at 29 minutes and 20 seconds. So let's flip this puppy back to 23 minutes and 20 seconds, and where are we? Well, the problem was is that what I'm saying is so that it can be truly a 20-minute effort, because I knew the climb would be about 14 minutes long. But the problem was that 6 minutes from that was the descent from Titans there. And so it would have made absolutely no sense to just, like, start an effort there. I did a bit of an effort up Titans, but that was, like, more just I kind of wanted to break things up a little bit. Hoped that someone would actually come with me. Nobody did, or at least, you know, we'd get 6, 7, 8 guys together. Nobody did, and was in a very dangerous spot, actually. But thank goodness we had that little plateau. That was like, the race would have been over right there. We had the plateau when they caught me. And so the group slowed down a little bit, so I was able to kind of catch on pretty quickly. But anyways, whoa, what just happened there? All right. Anything I miss? Perfect, yeah. All right, thanks everyone, and thanks so much for watching. We had a good turnout. Coming up next, you know what would be really cool is if tomorrow we rode on like the World Championship course and did like a race preview or something like that. But that would be kind of cool. You too, Henry. All right. That's all for now. I'm going to cool down, and the next time you see me, we will do Wednesday. Oh yeah, that's right. We got that workout coming up on Wednesday. So we'll do that one. That's gonna be a barn burner. It's gonna be 2 times 20 minutes. And pretty darn hard. I remember that workout from last year, and that last 20 minuter, actually it was the first 20 minuter that hurt the most, but the last 2 minutes of the last one hurt a lot. The first one hurt a lot just because, like, mentally you're like, holy jump, and I got another one of these to go. Are you out of your mind? Who wrote this workout? Any case, that's all for now, and I'll catch you later on Wednesday. All right. Let's not be delicate to shut this down. Everyone have a nice weekend. No Super Bowl this weekend. I don't know what we're going to be watching on television. No idea. All right. Let's move this off. Turn off.